everybody, it's your girl Krissy M, and welcome back to my channel, you guys. So for today's video, I am going to be giving you guys a makeup review from Shop Miss A. And you guys, can you believe that everything is a dollar? Like, seriously, everything is a freaking dollar. Like, what a steal. If you're on a budget, sis, this is the place for you to go ahead and shop. But before we go ahead and get into this video, you guys, make sure you guys go right now, click the subscribe button and the bell so you are notified when I do upload videos, you guys. And if you are new to my channel, hey doll, welcome, hey. My channel is all about fashion, beauty, and lifestyle. So let's go ahead and get into this video. You guys, so before we get into this makeup look, I wanted to show you guys some of the products that I did get from Shop Miss A, the $1 makeup store, okay, online. I didn't get a lot. Well, I did get a lot. I got like 11 pieces, but it's only because I've never tried the product and I didn't want to waste money on makeup that possibly I would never wear again or it probably wouldn't work. So let me show you guys exactly what I got. Okay, you guys, so I did get their Natural Finish. This is a full coverage, what, concealer? Medium to full coverage concealer. It's only $1.55, you guys, like seriously. Non-drying, creamy, long wear. Don't know how that's gonna work. I did get the Wonder Brow. This is a tinted brow pomade. The color in this one, you guys, I guess it's ebony, yes, ebony. So tiny. This reminds me of the Beverly Hills, Anastasia Beverly Hills, the one that I have. So that's like a dupe for that. I did get some setting powders, you guys. So we have a banana setting powder, and then we have just a regular white translucent setting powder. I did get the foundation, you guys. They have a freaking foundation in which I don't know if it's gonna be good or not, but it's supposed to be a pro layer, full coverage foundation. I really don't know about this, you guys. I don't know. I also got a loose pigmented, you know, for the eyes, for like an eyeshadow. The color for this one, I don't even know, it doesn't even say. And then we also got like a matte lip gloss or lipstick. And I actually got the lip liner to match it. And then we got some lashes. So like I said, everything, you guys, was only a dollar. So I don't know how this is gonna be. I want to test it out because I feel like it's a popular site and a lot of people shop it. So maybe some of their products are good, but if something doesn't work for me, you guys, I'm going to go in with my regular stuff and apply it to my face because I can't see myself going out in public or just being here, period, and putting this stuff on my face. So let's go ahead and get into these products. All right, you guys, so first we're going to start off with our brows. I never do my brows on camera because it takes me so long to do my brows. But I wanted to show you guys the difference between the Anastasia Beverly Hills and my brow dip. So here is the dollar brow dip, or Wonder Brow. And then here is my Anastasia Beverly Hills Wonder Brow. I mean, just, yeah, brow pomade. So it's similar, but much tinier, much smaller. Even the inside looks somewhat similar. This is the inside of the dollar, you guys. And this is the inside of my Anastasia, which I've used it like crazy. It's like my go-to. So we're gonna do our brows. Wish me luck, because I don't know about this. And I'm just fluffing out my brush, you guys. I actually got this eyebrow tool from, what, European Wax? Like years ago. This is what it's looking like as I'm like kind of smearing it and touching it. So it doesn't have the same consistency as the Anastasia Beverly Hills. Of course, it's only a freaking dollar. But let me try shading it in and see what it looks like shaded. So you guys, there's the first brow. It's not that bad. It really doesn't go on horribly. And it doesn't really have a smell either, you guys. So even though it was a dollar, you know how some cheap stuff can just smell? It doesn't really have a smell. So I am done doing the brows, and I can honestly say that that pomade is not so bad at all, you guys. When you are using the Wonder Brow for the Shop Miss, what is it, AOS, Shop Miss Miss A, I would make sure that you are using a brush that is specifically for the brows, and I would lightly put that onto the brush, because what can happen is that this will come up so dark that you'll end up rubbing it off just to get it kind of to more of a natural like look. Or, I mean, if you like it dark because you're about to go out or whatever, that's cool. But for everyday look, you guys, I think that's pretty good. I think it's totally worth the $1 that it is for the way that my brows turned out, because I seriously need a brow thread waxed and everything right now. So I think they did pretty good on it. I would totally invest in this. Like I said, it is the dupe for Anastasia Beverly Hills, and for a dollar. And look at my brows, you guys, like seriously. Okay, so I went ahead, you guys, and I added on my orange corrector. I didn't put it on camera because I don't want to, you know, make this long, this video super uber long. So I did use my Pro Concealer by LA Girl, and I also used the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. The color that I have is Deep Caramel, to go ahead and just kind of like conceal and, you know, hide all any of the dark spots from pretty much like my dark circles, because I don't know how this foundation is going to come onto my face. So next, you guys, I'm actually going to go in with the setting powder. As you guys already know, I like to set my concealer and my orange corrector before I add my foundation on, because I do have oily skin, and I have found out that when I do that, my skin and my makeup just looks flawless, and it lasts me so long throughout the day. So this is the White Translucent Setting Powder from the Shop Miss A website. Again, I don't know how it's going to be on my face. This is my first time trying all these products, you guys. I did not want to get like a lot of products because everything's a dollar and my skin is sensitive, and I didn't know how it would react, you know, with all this like cheap low-end products though. But all the stuff here is like freaking cruelty-free and is vegan-free, so it's pretty good, you guys. It's pretty good. So it looks like that. I would say this is like the dupe to the e.l.f. You guys see the e.l.f. Translucent Setting Powder? It's like the dupe to the e.l.f., I would say. But this is a dollar. This is probably like what, $8, $6 to $8. And again, you guys, I will post everything down below in the description. So if you guys are like, oh my gosh, where it is, I want to try, you guys go to the website, and I will put the links and tags to everything down below, so that way you guys could actually go and buy it yourself in person if you're liking it. Only if you like it. Okay, guys. So, White Translucent Powder. I'm going to use the more fluffy brush. This brush does not have a name or a number to it. I got it from Victoria's Secret as a package. So, yeah. And we're just going to kind of fluff some of this up here. I'm just going to put it in here. This is what it looks like, you guys. So, it's kind of like flimsy. It's not too bad. And like I said, I just normally like put it up underneath where I've concealed everything, just to lock it in. And oh, my T-zone is very oily. And it has no smell. It has no smell. It goes on very lightly though, you guys, very light. I would say get it. I mean, honestly, I would say get it. I mean, like a good translucent powder for only a dollar, I would say get it. I would invest into this. If you are a newbie getting into makeup, this probably is the best website for you to get really cheap, inexpensive makeup for you to test out and test onto your face until you kind of transition into the other brands. Because everything else can be very, very expensive. But this website right here, you guys, it's looking good. It's looking good. I'm just saying. It's looking pretty good. Okay, so that's the White Translucent Powder, you guys. We're going to move into the foundation. This is a Pro Wear Full Coverage Foundation. You guys, I'm going to try to like put maybe here, like the website kind of is showing the product and kind of giving a description of what it is. But again, you guys, this is all cruelty-free makeup. All cruelty-free, it's vegan and everything. So, I mean, it's pretty good, honestly. This is the foundation, you guys. Now, from the looks of this foundation, it looks nothing like my shade at all whatsoever. I took my time when I picked out this foundation because I wanted to make sure that I had got similar to a color that would go with my skin tone, just in case I had to blend it in with some of my other foundations. So I'm gonna show you guys on my hand what it looks like. So this is what it looks like here. And up against my hand, you guys, I'm just gonna do like a little squirt. That's the color of it. So when I go in to just kind of blend that out, you guys, it's not that bad. It actually is not too far off from my skin tone at all. It's really pretty good. If you guys see that, it does not have a strong smell. Honestly, there really is not that much of a smell. It smells just like maybe a baby doll, but very, 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 very light. I don't know if you guys can, if you guys have other makeup from other cheap makeup from like drugstores or whatever, and sometimes it can have a smell. There is really no smell to this at all. It's just very bland, and just look how it like dried out, you guys. Like, it's pretty much my skin tone. So because this one doesn't have like a little thing where I can just kind of put it on there, you guys, I'm gonna use my wet beauty blender and I'm gonna put some on there. I'm just gonna blend it out into my face. This isn't bad, this isn't bad. Let me see. Bad, you guys. I am going to go through and do my contour and everything and kind of make the color, you know, go correct. I would say if you do pick up the foundation, if you decide, hey, I want to try the foundation, try to get as close as to your skin tone as possible. If you have to pick up two, which I should have picked up two, I should have picked up probably this color here. I should have picked up like a little bit of a darker shade. Pick up two of them. I want to say these were only like a dollar. Again, everything's pretty much a dollar. But what I may have to do with this, you guys, I may have to set it with a setting powder on top of it, just because it's not like it's a matte foundation, or it's not like it's a matte, you know what I mean? So it's not really gonna be like, I can see my face like doing up later on. And if you guys can see here, I see like my little creases. So it's not like, you know, the perfect, the best foundation, but for a dollar, and if you are new to makeup and you want to get into makeup, this is like the perfect website for you guys. ShopMissA.com is the best website for you to get cheap makeup. You know, if you guys have photo shoots or something, and you're like, I don't want to waste my expensive ass makeup on this photo shoot. Get you, go to the website, girl, go to the website. I'm telling you, go to the website. I mean, you're gonna save so much money. All this stuff probably was like about 16, because you had tax and everything, you guys, and shipping. It was so inexpensive. Like, seriously, it's so worth it. Okay, you guys, I'm just going over the top part with this to fill it in. I'm gonna fix my baby hairs over. Alright, you guys, so I'm gonna move into lashes. I did add a little bit of the setting powder over the face just to kind of set the foundation itself. Because, like I said, it's not the best foundation, but you know, I'm gonna be going out to the grocery store and I kind of want my face to kind of be like a natural state and not look oily or dewy. So, you guys, I actually am gonna do my lashes now. I got three styles of lashes, they were only a dollar once again. So, the first style of lashes is called Tori. They're more like flared out. They're really, really cute. They're kind of, they're really full. I like full lashes. My next style is called Vanessa. And then I have Jessica here. Okay, so the style of lashes that I'm actually going to use for my face today, I'm actually gonna use Tori. I like Tori. I'm feeling Tori right now. I think Tori is gonna be good. And I'm actually going to put on my lash glue. Now these are 3D foaming. Now, these are not like the lashes, the 100% make lashes that I have for my brand website. But, I mean, for a dollar, they're super cute. And they're super doable. You could totally rock these out with a cute makeup look and it just totally look like a regular pair of lashes. So I would definitely invest into those. Okay guys, let me get my glue on here. I'm gonna apply them, then we'll be right back and we're gonna do a little bit of highlight, conceal, and contour. All right guys, so here are the lashes. They're super cute, you guys. They're really cute. I love that they had that little black band on them already, so it wasn't like I had to force them to get on. They went on really nicely, but I think they're super cute for a dollar. That's why I got three. Okay, so I did want to tell you guys about the lashes. The lashes are, let's see, they're made with quality synthetic fibers, and they're cruelty-free. So it is like a faux mink, but it's a synthetic faux mink. That's why it kind of has like a little bit of a, you know, it's not soft. But faux mink lashes are super soft. They look so natural, almost like human hair. So keep that in mind too. If you're allergic to synthetic, this may not be a good product for you. But if you're not, sis, these for a dollar, it's so for you. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and get into the highlight. I did get a concealer. This concealer is medium to full coverage, a natural finish. It is non-drying, creamy, long-wearing. On the back, it says it corrects imperfections and dark circles. I'm trying to see this, okay? Even though I already used something for my dark circles, but still. I wanna see if it's gonna give me like a nice like blend out, you know, to do a highlight. So let's go ahead and put it on. It also says apply a small amount over blemishes or under eyes and then blend out. Start with a thin layer and build as needable and set with powder. So it is blendable. It is telling you to set it with powder. Like I said again, guys, it's freaking a dollar. The color that I have is soft tan. For you guys that wanna know my shades and my colors, soft tan is the color for this one. And it'll be down in the description below. So let's go ahead and get this on our face. I'm gonna go in with my damp beauty blender again. And there's like no little brushes or anything for this, you guys. So we're just kind of squirting it out there. And we're gonna apply it. That I would not use this to do your like highlight. I would not use this, and I'm gonna tell you why. Right up under here, my eye, where I've already applied the foundation and everything, already did like an orange correction and everything, you can see where it's trying to kind of smear out, and you can kind of see like my dark circles starting to pop up because I have applied that. So I wouldn't use this to do a blend out under the eye or to achieve a highlight. I would strictly just use this one before you add on your foundation as a buildable, you know, correction concealer, because now I'm gonna have to go back through with my regular concealer just to make sure I'm not showing any dark circles up underneath there, underneath my eye. So all right, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now, and then I'm gonna get back and we're going to finish up this video. All right, you guys, so now I had to go back through with my Fenty Beauty, you guys, just kind of blend that out a little bit. It's not the best thing that I had to put the other concealer on, but we're gonna make it do what it do. I am going to add on my banana powder.
And that's just for my highlight, you guys. I always do a banana powder to highlight. I always use a damp beauty blender to apply it. So this just set it a little bit better, you guys, with the banana powder. Hopefully. You guys, I'm gonna finish this up here and then we're gonna move on to the lip and then we're gonna be done with this makeup review. All right, you guys. So after I was done brushing off the banana powder, I actually let the banana powder sit for about 5 minutes. I went ahead and I added on my like little contour and my little highlights and everything like that, you guys. So now I'm gonna go in with the final product because again, this is a review for one product and one brand and I don't wanna be intertwining brands. So we're gonna go in with the Wonder Matte Lipstick. This color is called Tease. And then I actually have the Wonder Lip Liner in the color Tease as well. So we're gonna lip line the lip. We're gonna add on the lipstick and then hopefully we'll be done. So here's the lipstick. I can honestly say that the lipstick isn't bad. It dries very quickly. It is like very lightweight. It's not as thick going on. It's not bad, but I am going to cover it with some gloss, you guys. I'm a glossy girl. I'm not really a matte girl when it comes to lipsticks sometimes, unless it's like a red or a pretty pink. So I'm actually going to cover it up a little bit, but I just wanted to show you guys how it looks on the lips. I'm just gonna gloss it a little, you guys. You guys, so that concludes today's video for Shop Miss A. If you guys have not checked out their website, go ahead. I'll put it actually down below here. I'm gonna drop it down in my description box as well for you guys to be able to click on it and shop it. But like I said, it's $1. Everything's $1 pretty much. There's certain things that are more expensive, but it's just like random things that you wouldn't think to buy. But everything's $1, you guys. And I honestly think that it's totally worth it. If you are a beginner, like I said, trying out makeup, this brand is for you, sis. Like, you need to go on the website, get you your basic necessities, and get you a good little makeup glam going on. And I promise you, you're not gonna be disappointed at all whatsoever. So, again, you guys, if you have not yet already subscribed to my channel, make sure you guys go right now, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you are notified when I upload new videos. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, loves.